Hello, John Talley here with Partzilla.com. Today, we're going to be revisiting a subject that I covered almost 5 years ago, and that was the current crop of batteries and chargers that were available out in the power sports world. Well, that started off with just the standard lead acid and then AGM and then sealed AGMs, but now we need to add in lithium ion. So what we're going to do is do a quick recap on the lead acid and the AGM, and then we're going to talk about if going with a lithium battery is right for you, and if so, which charger should you go with, depending on all of your needs at home. So if you're ready, we'll dive back into this project. So let's go. So, without getting too deep into each one's construction, let's at least review. Now, the lead acid, it is basically a set of plates inside. You've got a positive plate, which is called your cathode, and on the negative side, you've got the anode. Now, each cell inside of this, that produces roughly 2 volts, and so you're going to connect those in series to get whatever voltage that you're after. For example, you know, our 12-volt battery, it's going to have, you know, 6 cells, and that is swimming in a sea of sulfuric acid. Now, with this design, that means it can deliver really high surge currents, and that's very important in the automotive and especially the marine industry. Because it is a simpler design, it has to have a vent, and sometimes that may not be what you're after. One of the biggest disadvantages of this battery is you have to maintain it. So you have to keep an eye on this level here. So if it gets down below that lower bar, well, then you've got to bring in some distilled water to bring that acid level up to where it's covering all of the plates. Very important. You fail to do that, you're going to burn out the top of your plates and greatly shorten the life of your battery. Now, how did we get around that? Well, we moved up to what they call the AGM battery, absorbed glass mat. Now, with this type, you're using not so much an acid, but an electrolyte, and it is already in a contained package. You add it into the battery, let it settle, and then charge. And at that point, you seal it up. Now, what are some of the advantages of the AGM? They actually have fiberglass mats in between the battery plates. Now, these mats, they absorb and hold the battery's acid or electrolyte, which basically makes them, like I said, maintenance free. The mat also ensures the electrolyte remains in close contact with those plates, and that really helps it out on its efficiency. And once again, this is a sealed design, and that also has the added bonus, it doesn't have to be mounted vertically. You can actually lay this down on its side and it'll still operate as designed. Now, what are the real advantages over the lead acid? Well, the AGM batteries, well, they're known for very high performance and they can still deliver that high power demand as well as having a longer lifespan than your regular flooded type conventional batteries. You can actually get these where they are a deep cycle. In other words, they're used to discharging all the way and yet they can be brought back relatively safely if you have a good charger. And that's really sought after, especially in the marine and RV industries. It's really a tough battery. They're more capable of taking really hard vibration and shocks. And that's especially important on the power sports side, not so much on the sport bikes, but any of your sport ATVs or side-by-sides. That can be a rough ride at times, and they do a great job of surviving in that environment. Now, I don't want to beat up on the lead acid battery completely. They do have a couple of advantages over the AGM, so I have to mention those. One, they are much, much cheaper. Second, they can operate in much hotter and colder environments than the AGM. And the AGMs, you really have to be careful not to overcharge them, whereas the lead acid, it can put up with a little bit more abuse. Now, your lead acid, that's where you're mainly gonna find it in work environments such as a farm. But for power sports and automotive, you can rest assured it's probably gonna be an AGM of some type. Now, there are a couple of different types of AGM batteries. Now, you've got the one on my right where they ship it with the battery and the electrolyte. When you're ready to put it in service, you put in the electrolyte pack, you let it settle, charge it, and then seal it up. Now also, you can get one where that part is already done, and it's sitting basically in a shelf mode, if you will. It's already set up, the electrolyte's in place, and it's sealed. All you have to do is just put its starting charge on it, bring it all the way up, and then install it. All right, guys, let's talk about that lithium ion. Now granted, it is a rechargeable battery like everything else that you see on the table, but its main advantage is it has a high energy density, it is very lightweight, and it has a long life cycle. Now granted, the one thing that all three of these batteries have in common is they have some type of anode reacting against a cathode, and that's what's giving you your voltage per cell. This one, for an anode, it usually uses a graphite. The cathode, it's going to be some type of lithium. Now that could be a cobalt oxide, it could be an iron phosphate, any other type of lithium compound. And all this is swimming in an electrolyte that facilitates the movement of lithium ions in between those two electrodes. Now, during the charging and discharging, lithium ions move back and forth in between the anode and cathode through the electrolyte. Now, this process is highly efficient and allows for high energy storage. Somebody a lot smarter than me came up with this particular design, and I'm glad they did. Now, of course, these are going to be in a sealed environment, and this prevents leaking of that electrolyte. This design is safe and reliable across, well, a lot of different applications. Now, one of the biggest advantages of this type of system, it can deliver a lot of energy in a very, very small package. Hence why just about every phone you're going to find out there, it's going to have a lithium battery in it. Not a big surprise. Another big advantage is they are very lightweight. I put these on a scale earlier, and the equivalent YTX20HL was 13 pounds, and this one came in a little over 3. So you're talking about in excess of a 10 pound difference in between the two batteries. And as far as power delivery, this is a very, very strong unit. It'll actually spin over the engine faster than the regular AGM battery. I installed a 30 amp hour in my race car. I was a little bit hesitant to do it at first, but overall I've been very pleased with it. It cranks that car with authority. Inline six, high compression, spins it over, no problem. I've had it in there for about 6 months. These batteries can go through hundreds, if not thousands, of charge cycles. Also have a low discharge rate, meaning that they can retain their charge sitting still for a long time. Case in point, I had one identical to this in one of our units, stored it away at the very back of the lot in a storage container for about 7 months. Brought it out, no, it didn't start. Had 1 volt left in it. So basically, it went through the summer where I guarantee you it was north of 130 degrees in that container, and then through most of the winter. So no, it didn't stand a chance. Now, who do I blame for that? Me. Should have brought that battery out, put it on the counter, and just put a maintainer on it. Okay, lesson learned. Now, what we haven't discussed is just how fast you can charge one of these. I mean, it's at least 2 to 3 times quicker than an AGM or a standard lead acid. Another big advantage is, well, there's no memory effect, where if you don't charge it up all the way, it'll create that memory as its max, and then it won't want to go past it. Lithium ion, it doesn't have that hurdle that it needs to get over. Another thing, it has a wide temperature range. Most lithium ions, they're good from minus 20 degrees Celsius all the way up to 60 degrees Celsius. I mean, that is a wide range of different environmental conditions. I'm not sure I want to be in an area that's minus 20 to begin with. All right, so we've been talking about all the pros, let's talk about some of the cons that can be associated with these. One, it is very expensive, probably in most cases 10 times more than a lead acid and at least 5 to 6 more than the equivalent AGM. Beyond that, well, you need to have the right charger for that. And we'll talk about chargers in a moment, but you must have a lithium-ion capable charger. You do not want to charge this up with just a regular charger, even if it is a smart charger, but definitely not one of those old buzz boxes that we used to have from Sears or the equivalent, because the charge rate is high. That wants to see in between 13.5 and 14 volts, but then it wants to taper off and then slowly bring it up. If you just hit it full wide open with a regular AGM charger, you're going to damage the electronics inside of this box, and there's no bringing it back after that. Now, they do have a wide temperature range, but you really need to handle them properly. Otherwise, they can be a fire hazard. They, of course, are very expensive batteries, and they require protection circuits to prevent overcharging and discharging completely. Now, the good part, a lot of them, like this restart one here, it senses when it's going into a discharge state and will stop it. And it actually has like a restart button on it where it can more or less reactivate itself. What you don't want to do to a lithium ion is completely flatten it out and leave it there. That's when it can get into trouble and there's really no bringing it back, and I wouldn't want to. If they're fully discharged, they're done for a long period of time. And when that could be said for the AGM or the lead acid as well. You let either one of those sit at a very low voltage, it's going to sulfate over. You might be able to bring one back, but you've severely shortened its life expectancy. There is no doubt. Really need to make sure that your machine is capable of charging it, and what you're looking for is an output in between 13.6 and 14.6 volts. Otherwise, it's not going to charge it properly. Now, especially if you've got a pre-1990 powersports or motorcycle, that's probably not going to work with your existing regulator rectifier, and you may need to upgrade to a higher output where it can accommodate this type of battery. So that brings us to the chargers. Which one should you go with? Well, that's kind of a loaded question. You could get one as small as this little 800 milliamp one, and it can charge regular AGM batteries. It can also do the lithium battery. Trick is, it's gonna take its time. Now, when you're charging this battery, it wants to see roughly 1.5 amps at in between 5 and 10 hours. You try to do that with 800 milliamps, it's going to take you in between 15 and 20 to bring it up. Another disadvantage with a much smaller one, depending on which battery you're trying to charge, sometimes they need a little bit more push to start the charging procedure. And your smaller ones, like the 800 or even this little 750, they don't quite have that oomph to get things going. And once you get away from just your smaller ones, these I would typically just use for maintaining a battery. I mean, can they charge one of these? Yes. Can they really bring it back to life? No. But as you move into the larger units, they have more capability, they have more features. Like this 4-amp one, it can do 12 volt, it can do 6, it can do the AGM or the flooded, and then it also can do the lithium. Well, all right, guys, that's going to wrap up this video. Well, listen, if you need batteries or chargers or tools or whatever you need for your machine, why don't you come see us at Partzilla.com and we can get you taken care of. If you have any questions or comments about this video, leave them in the section below and I'll do my best to answer them. And hey, if you like what you see, go ahead and hit that subscribe button along with that notification bell. That way you can keep up with whatever I'm working on or talking about. Listen, we just want to say thank you for shopping here with us at Partzilla, and we will see you in the next video. Y'all have a great day.